हेलो एवरीवन, कंटिन्यूइंग विद यूनिट 3 दैट इज फ्रिक्शन एंड बिल ड्राइव्स। इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फ्रिक्शन इन फ्लैट कॉलर बेयरिंग्स। एज इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ पिवट्स एंड वी हैव डिराइव्ड एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर फ्रिक्शनल टॉर्क फॉर द पिवट्स, assuming two different conditions. One is based on uniform pressure and second based on uniform wear. Here also we will derive the expression based on uniform wear as well as based on uniform pressure separately for a flat collar bearing. So as we know that collar bearing is the bearing which are attached along the lengths of the shaft. So here we have a flat collar bearing with radius R1, as you can see in this figure, as radius R1 as the external radius of the collar and radius R2 which is equals to the radius of the shaft as the internal radius of the collar. We have a axial load capital W acting along the axis of the shaft, and the collar bearing is used to take the axial thrust load along its length it has been situated. So as considering uniform pressure will be our first derivation for a flat collar bearing. So let W is the load transmitted over the bearing surface, as I've just said. R1 is the external radius of collar bearing, R2 is internal radius of collar bearing, P represents the intensity of pressure per unit area of bearing surface between the rubbing surfaces, and mu represents the coefficient of friction between the shaft and the collar. So let's consider, as you can see in this figure, a small ring which is been shown by this shaded portion of thickness dr at a distance r from the center, having a collar whose internal radius is r2 and external radius is r1. So now we have considered a small ring which is having a radius r and it is having a thickness dr. So when the pressure is uniformly distributed over the bearing area, then P is equals to load upon area, and area of the collar will be pi R1 square minus R2 square. We know that area of a circle with internal radius R2 and external radius R1, area will be pi R1 square minus R2 square, that is pi into external radius square minus internal radius square. So intensity of pressure P will be equals to load upon area. Now consider a ring, as I just mentioned, of radius small r and thickness dr. Area of the ring will be 2 pi r dr. We know that vertical load transmitted to the ring will be pressure into area, that is P into A, that is P into 2 pi r dr. Also frictional resistance to sliding on the ring acting tangentially at radius r will be mu into the normal load, that is mu into del W. Del W is P into 2 pi r dr. So frictional resistance Fr will be 2 pi mu P r dr. Now frictional torque on the elementary ring will be frictional resistance into r, that is Fr is 2 pi mu P r dr into r will give frictional torque. So frictional torque on the ring will become 2 pi mu p r square dr. Till now it is clear. Let it be question second. So total torque on the ring will be how much? It will be, so total frictional torque will be, by integrating the above equation within the limits R2 to R1, will get the total frictional torque. So T will be equals to R2 to R1 integrating 2 pi mu P R square dr, where 2 is constant, pi is constant, mu is constant, P is constant, and integration of R square is R cube by 3, and the limits are, lower limit is R2 and upper limit is R1, where R1 is external radius of the collar bearing and R2 is internal radius of collar bearing. So integrating to get total frictional torque, 2 by 3 pi mu p constant, R1 cube minus R2 cube. Put the value of p as w upon pi R1 square minus R2 square. This pi and pi will cancel. So the final expression will be 2 by 3 mu w R1 cube minus R2 cube upon R1 square minus R2 square. So for a flat collar bearing, considering uniform pressure, total frictional torque will be 2 by 3 mu w R1 cube minus R2 cube upon R1 square minus R2 square, where mu is coefficient of friction, w is the axial load, R1 is the external radius of the collar, and R2 is the internal radius of the collar bearing. Clear? Now, for a multi-collar bearing, let's take this also. So in case of a multi-collar bearing with say n collars, then say intensity of uniform pressure becomes total load upon number of collars into bearing area of one collar. So if n is the number of collars, so expression becomes P is equal to W upon NA, where A represents bearing area of one collar and W represents the total load on the shaft, and N is the number of collars. So P is equal to W upon N pi R1 square minus R2 square. Yes, so now we'll start with considering the second case, that is considering uniform wear. So for a flat collar bearing having a flat collar of internal radius R2 and external radius R1, internal radius is also equals to the radius of the shaft. We have a shaft having axial load W. So let W is the load transmitted over the bearing surface, R1 is external radius of collar bearing, R2 is internal radius of collar bearing, P is the intensity of pressure per unit area of bearing surfaces between rubbing surfaces. In this case also, as we have done with various types of pivot bearings considering uniform wear, the same kind of process will follow to derive the expression for total torque on a flat collar bearing considering uniform wear. So let mu is the coefficient of friction, and when the wear is uniformly distributed over the bearing area, then we know that product of pressure into radius is constant, or we can write P is equals to C by R. Now consider again, consider a ring of radius r, small r, and thickness dr of the bearing area. So area of this elementary ring will be 2 pi r dr, area of the bearing surface will be 2 pi r dr, vertical load transmitted to the ring will be pressure into area, that is p into 2 pi r dr. Also p is equals to सी बाय आर, सो वर्टिकल लोड ट्रांसमिटेड टू द रिंग बिकम्स 2 पाई सी डी आर. टोटल लोड ट्रांसमिटेड टू द रिंग विल बी इंटीग्रेटिंग इट फ्रॉम आर टू टू आर वन, वी गेट डब्ल्यू इक्वल्स टू 2 पाई सी आर वन माइनस आर टू, और वी कैन राइट सी इज इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू अपॉन 2 पाई आर वन माइनस आर टू. लेट इट बी इक्वेशन वन. सो वी हैव derived an expression for C which is equals to W upon 2 pi R1 minus R2, and we have marked it as equation 1. Again, vertical resistance to sliding tangentially at radius R will be mu into the normal force or load, that is mu into del W. Put the value of del W as P into 2 pi R dr multiplied by mu, we get frictional resistance. Frictional torque is frictional resistance into R on the ring. So frictional torque on the ring will be Fr into R. Put Fr as 2 pi mu p R dr multiplied by R. We get 2 pi mu p R square dr. Put the value of P as C by R. We get frictional torque on the ring as 2 pi mu c r dr. Now for the total torque on the collar, we'll be integrating this equation within the limits from r2 to r1, we'll get the total frictional torque on the collar bearing. So integrate this equation from lower limit r2 to upper limit r1, we get total frictional torque T as R2 to R1 integrating it with 2 pi mu C R dr. Here 2 is constant, pi is constant, mu C is constant. So integration of R dr will be R square by 2. Putting the value of R2 and R1 as the lower and upper limit respectively, we have half pi mu C R1 square minus R2 square. Putting the value of C total frictional torque will be not half, it will be pi mu C R1 square minus R2 square, as this 2 and the R square by 2, 2 and 2 will be cancelled in numerator and denominator. We will get total frictional torque as pi mu c r1 square minus r2 square. Also we know that the value of c is w upon 2 pi r1 minus r2. So put this in equation third, we will get total frictional torque as 1 by 2 mu w r1 plus r2, as r1 square minus r2 square can be written as r1 plus r2 into R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2 and this R1 minus R2 cancel each other, pi and pi cancel each other, it becomes half mu W R1 plus R2, which is the final expression for the total frictional torque in case of a flat collar bearing considering uniform wear, where mu represents the coefficient of friction, capital W represents the total axial load, R1 is the external radius of the collar bearing, whereas R2 represents the internal radius of the collar bearing, or R2 is also equals to the radius of the shaft. Clear? So we have derived an expression for the total frictional torque for a flat collar bearing considering both the cases. Hope you are clear. So for more videos you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Gagan Bansal, or for any query you can directly mail me at gaganbansal12345@gmail.com or gaganbansal@geu.ac.in. Thank you so much.